praise this morning and let's worship him, for he is a good God and he is so faithful. Lord, we thank you. We have invited him in this place this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, you're worthy. You're worthy, God. Hey! Father, and we worship you in this place today, God. You're so worthy of all of our praise. You're so worthy, God. You're so worthy, God. Come on, just one more time. Lift him up and give him praise. Let's just welcome him here. God, you're so welcome in our presence, Father. We are here, God, to lift you up, to make you known, God. We are here, God, to lift you on high, to exalt your name, Jesus, above everything, God. Above every disease, above every sickness, Father God. Above every poverty, Father. We thank you, God, that you are worthy. Your name is great and to be exalted, Father. We magnify you, we magnify you. Now let's just give him a hand clap of praise. God, you're worthy. You're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, we just want to welcome you to Life Fellowship Church. We are a great church. I think we are. Not just because of us, but all of y'all. Y'all make the church. And we love to come and we love to worship and we love to lift the name of Jesus. And we also like to love on you. So we want you to step out of your aisle and shake somebody's hand. Find someone that you may not have seen, maybe a new face. Tell them how glad you are to see him here this morning in the house of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, reign, God. Father, fill this place, God, with your presence, Jesus. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. Thank you, God. Ready?
Power.
we magnify your name, Jesus. We magnify your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, come on, church, your breakthrough is on the other side of your praise. I just feel that rolling in my spirit this morning. If you've been dealing with things in your life, and you deal with them every day, day in and day out, God is telling you your breakthrough is this morning. So come on and praise him and worship through it, because see, Satan can't stand it when you worship the Almighty God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Woo, he has to leave in the name of Jesus. God, we praise your name. We praise your name. We praise your name. We praise your name, God. I'm going to sing. I'm going to shout. Hallelujah. For the rest of my life. Going to sing. Going to shout. Hallelujah, for the rest of my life, I'm gonna sing, gonna shout, hallelujah, for the rest of my life, I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, hallelujah, for the rest of my life, I'm gonna sing, gonna shout, hallelujah, for the rest of my life, I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, hallelujah, for the rest of my life. Come on and just lift the name of Jesus. Father, we honor you today. God, we thank you for the victory. We thank you, God, for the strongholds that are coming down in our lives, oh God. We thank you, God, that you go before us, God, and you fight the warfare, Father. You go before us, God, and you make a way, God, where there seems to be no way, Father. We give you thanks, God, and we give you honor and glory, God. Holy are you, God. We are speechless in your presence, Father. I am speechless in your presence, God. I am in so awe of you, God. Your love, God, is never ending, God. It's unfailing. It surpasses all of our knowledge, God, all of our understanding, Father. How that you could love someone like me, but you do. And God, I give you thanks for it, God. Oh, come on, just tell him thanks. Tell him you love him. We honor you, God. We honor you, God. We honor you, Lord. Oh, we honor you, God. Fill this place with your glory, God. Fill this place with your glory, God. Oh, unending, but you're always on. Oh, unfailing God, but never unkind. Think about it. Oh, unmerited, yes. Favor is mine. Oh, undeserving, Lord. Mercy and his grace that's unmerited. It's never ending. It's never unfailing. We invite you this morning, if you don't know him, we want our prayer team to come. We have an awesome prayer team that will stand in the gap with you and for you. Whatever needs you may have walked in these doors with this morning, we know that we are people. We have needs. There's things that we go through in life. But you know what? We also know that we serve a mighty God. And he is able to meet that need, whatever it is, how big it is, how small it is. We want you to come. They will stand in the gap and pray with you this morning and believe God for you. Believe God with you through it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And if you don't know him, this is your moment to meet the best thing that you will ever find. He's better than any drug. He's better than anything that you may run for or run after that can never fill you up, but he can. He can. Hallelujah. He can. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we wait patiently for you. We have heard your cry, God. Establish our ways, God. Set our feet, God, on solid rock. That, Father, we'll be able to stand the test of times, God. That, Lord, the victory, God, is nigh. We thank you, Jesus. Your name is above every name. King of kings and Lord of lords. Here we are, oh God, here we are. Come on, just lift your hands and tell him, here I am, oh God. Here I am. Fill me with your glory, God. The most beautiful name of all names. Oh, yes, you are. Jesus, the only name that brings healing and strength.
When I speak your name, all the darkness in my mind flees. Aren't you thankful for the presence of the Lord and for His faithfulness? Amen. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank You because You are trustworthy, and we choose to put our trust in You, Lord. And Father, I ask You to minister in the lives of every individual and every family that is represented by the ones present here today, God. I ask You to get involved in their life. In the name of Jesus, You're the one that said, my grace is sufficient for you. I'm asking for that grace to be manifest in the circumstances of their lives, God. If it's on a physical level, Lord, we're asking for there to be healing. Healing is the children's bread, Father. If it's on a relationship level with family or on the job or things of those natures, Father, I ask You to get involved. You speak, Lord, and You work with the circumstances and the situation. Lord, I specifically ask You to work where their finances are concerned, God, that there would be relief coming because You bring solution and You bring workable situations. Father, bless this people, I pray, today. May it be visible that they know and serve the living God by the blessings that are manifest into their lives, Father. Minister to their children right straight across the board, Father. If there are rebellious ones, I ask You, Lord, to get involved in that individual's life, that there be a breakthrough, that can be broken and there can be peace and harmony in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank You, Lord, for Your grace is more and is sufficient for us. We thank You for it, Lord. Amen.
Freedom is not free, is it? There have been many that have gone before us. Some of you have relatives and loved ones, grandfathers, who have paid that price. And this morning, we'd like to recognize all of those that are here with us who are currently serving in the military in any form or fashion. If you're here with us, would you please stand? If you have served in the military, go ahead. Those of you that have served, if you would please stand, each and every one of you. Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah. And remain standing, please. And if those of you who have loved ones who are currently serving, some boys are in training or overseas, I believe even that Pebble's son is watching this morning via Japan. We want to stand if you have a relative that is in service. Amen. Amen. We give them honor this morning. Remain standing. Everyone stand with me as we go to prayer for those who have serving or have served our country. Father, we thank you for those who have said they will go wherever they're sent to defend the liberty that we enjoy as a public. We ask your blessing be upon them wherever they may be, in foreign soil or here in America. We ask that your blessing be upon their household as well, upon their family that misses them dearly. We ask that you strengthen and encourage them in their resolve, Lord. We ask your blessing and comfort be with those who have lost loved ones to the conflicts that we have faced in this state, United States of America. Lord, we thank you for these that serve us, and we give you honor, and we take time to remember this morning. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Okay, everybody join with me. Let's say hi, Ethan, okay? Look at the camera back there. Let's wave. Hi, Ethan. We love you. Can't wait till you're back. Okay, I get these texts sometimes on Sunday mornings, and this morning I got a text from Ethan. I'm going to move to this side because Pebble's over there crying. So, but he texted and said, I love you, miss you guys, I'm going to watch the service today. And he says, I love my LFC family. And so we love him too, and we have so many people that serve here. We pray for them, God's protection, his angels to be upon them, and blessings. God is just doing such mighty works in their lives. So, and we just want to welcome any guests that we have here today. We welcomed Ethan, so we want to welcome our guests that are here today. And we do have some guests. Andrea and Madison are here. They are longtime members. They moved to Washington, and they're back to visit. And she said, it feels just the same when I walk through the door. So we miss them dearly, but it's so good to have you guys here today. Yes, yes. And but there is a connection card in front of you. If you can fill that out, drop that in the offering, and we will send you more information about our church, all the activities that's going on, and just we just want to love on you and be a blessing to you. Also, any praise reports or prayer requests, just use that card as well on the back. We are diligent to pray over you and to rejoice with you when God answers those prayers. So we have Life Connection class coming up Saturday, June the 1st. And also inside your bulletin, there is a form there. If you are interested in learning more about the church or becoming a member, this is a great class to come to. It talks about what we believe and how we minister here. Some of the ministries that are here is a great class to attend. And it's Saturday, June the 1st from 10 a.m. to noon. And we provide breakfast and child care. So we're going to take care of you and pamper you while you're here. And then speaking of connection, our youth had a great weekend this weekend. They had a girls and guys night out. I think the girls spent the night with Courtney and Lisa all night long, huh? All night long. And the guys were with Cody and Jason all night long. And then not only did they do that, but after they stayed up all night long, then they went to the park and had a picnic and played volleyball. Now, that I admire y'all for all of that energy there, so they had over 20 kids there, just 20 were there in attendance, and they did a lock-in not too long ago. There was 40 here. God is doing such a work in the youth department. Let's just give Cody and Courtney a big hand. And maybe we can rub up against them and get some of that energy, too. So, and then also we are making a directory, and you will find inside your bulletin, if you are interested in being in the directory, fill that out. And we're taking pictures right after church, so you can meet us in the foyer on the right-hand side. We'll take your picture. We want to have a directory so everybody can know who everybody is. And we just invite you to do that. And then we have coming up, the Kenya missions trip is 16 days to their departure. That is coming up fast. This has been something we have prayed over, we have sought the Lord over, and now we're expecting God to do mighty, great and mighty things on this trip. And we want to ask you to start praying now. We have a sign-up sheet on the information booth. We want to ask you to start praying now. If you can, we're trying to fill up every day with at least one person praying that day. If there's two or three, that is wonderful. But if you can pray with us while they're there, before they leave, while they're getting things ready, And then they will be there about 12 to 13 days, so we want to pray over those days too. And so we're just gearing up. They're going to be there in ministering, but we're going to be there in spirit. And we're going to be paving a way for them so that it will go easy and ministry will take place and lives will be changed over that. And then Pastor Danny is not here today, and he is getting some refreshing. He's with a friend of his, a pastor friend of his. And he has got a special message for you on Sunday morning. I love it when he goes away, because when he comes back, that's going to be the best message you've ever heard. So he will be in the pulpit next Sunday morning to minister. And I just believe that God is doing just a mighty, mighty, mighty work in his life. And just remember to pray for him this week. God bless Pastor Danny and help him just to have some fun and relax and be refreshed. So, it's time for offering. But I just want you to look to the person on your left and right. Look to your right and say, I'm so glad to see you. Now look to your left and say, thank you for sitting by me. We all love each other, don't we? Well, it is, we're going to receive our offering. We're going to ask the ushers to prepare. You know, as we were talking about our freedom today, I was believing the Lord, and I was preparing and praying over my offering today, and this is what the Lord spoke to me. Today, we are free to give. We are free to give. And we have been given too, a lot. God has blessed us. We are free to give to invest into souls. We are free to give to advance the kingdom of God. We have the opportunity to give freely. And as we freely give, God blesses us abundantly back. So what I did was I filled out my offering, and I like to pray over it. I wanted to take it in our hands, and I want to pray, because not only are we investing into what God is doing in the kingdom of God, we're investing into what God's doing in Kenya, we're investing in what God is doing in Canada, we are investing in what God is doing in our children, we are leaving a heritage, a legacy for our children's children. We want to make sure the word goes forth and it is established and it is established in what God is calling us to do, and that we're going to leave a heritage of what God has called us in our children and our children's children. And this is one way we do. We give unto the Lord. He blesses it. And let's just take it in our hands, and let's pray over it. Let's take our tithes and offerings and be serious about it with God. And let's believe for the heritage that he is speaking to our hearts. Father, I just lift up this offering before your throne today. And I ask you, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father God, that you will take this offering. Father, I ask you to advance your kingdom, Father, for your sake. I pray that you advance and make a way for our children and our children's children. I pray, God, that you will use these funds to help us to leave a legacy and advance the kingdom of God in this world, to make a difference in this world. And Father God, as we give unto you, Father, there is never a time that you do not give back to us. And I ask to you to give to your people, to bless them abundantly, bless them in their relationships, their families, their friends, their finances. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Ushers, if you'll come on and serve the congregation. God is so good to us, isn't he? And we're going to freely give to him. Ushers, go ahead and serve us. And I'm going to ask all the kiddos, come on up, and we're going to bless you. Y'all come on up and start getting ready.
Yeah.
We're going to bless the children. If you'll stretch your hands, and let's just bless the children. Lord, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause His face to shine upon you and give you grace and give you mercy. I pray, Father God, that your angels will surround them and keep them all the days of their life. I pray, God, that they will be anointed as they follow their divine destiny that you have called them to. I pray that you bless them. I pray that you bless them with good friends. I pray that you bless their homes, their families, their friends, and let your mercy be upon them all the days of their life. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Well, it is Memorial Day, and we have a long weekend in store. We're going to be praying for our military, and we can enjoy some time off as well, can't we? I just thank God for His faithfulness. As I was standing up here this morning, when I look at you guys, I keep pausing, but the reason I keep pausing is because it's like the Lord, every time I look at a face, I see the Lord saying, I love that person, I love that person. I'm working in their lives, I'm working miracles, I'm doing something. Even as I was praying over the children, these are not just little children. This is God's plan, it's His divine plan, and He's raising them up. This morning I have just been overwhelmed when I look at the congregation, because I'm overwhelmed at God's love for us and how He wants to bless us and speak to our hearts. And He just wants to shout into our ears what He has in store for us. So hang on. God's got more in store for you today. And we do have a very, very special guest speaker today, and that is Nathan Hooper. And Nathan, let's give Nathan a big hand. We all love Nathan around here. He has been such a blessing to our church family. He just goes around and he loves everybody, even from the infants, you know, to the oldest we have. Everyone loves Nathan, and it's because he pours his heart and he genuinely loves other people. And today he's going to speak from his heart, something that God has spoke to his heart, and I believe we're going to receive a great blessing from that. Nathan, come on up. Let's give him a big hand.
Hallelujah. Well, let's give God a hand of praise. Amen. He's truly worthy this morning. Wow. On Wednesday nights, I usually speak down there, and it's a little different look up here. And I hope I don't run around too much. I might get tangled up in something. It's wonderful to see your lovely faces here this morning. And I agree with Miss Beverly that God knows you're here this morning. He has something in store for you. Hallelujah. I want to preach this morning on winning in warfare. Hallelujah. Let's look at Ephesians chapter 6, verses 11 through 13. It tells us to put on the whole armor of God that we might be able to stand against the wiles, the strategies, the ploys of the enemy, the devil, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. I know sometimes it might seem like it, but we wrestle against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. And Paul repeats himself and he says, wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand in that evil day, withstand, and having done all, to stand. Praise God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for your word, which is alive and powerful. You know each one that's here this morning. Hallelujah. I'm trying not to be emotional, but I know we've seen some battles, Father, in our lives, that people are going through struggles even this morning. But you are here to hear and answer every prayer that we pray. You're here to minister to every need of individual that's here. And we give you praise and we give you glory in Jesus' name. Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm in a battle. I'm in a warfare. You know, there's no country of Sweden that we can run to for neutrality. There's no ground of mediocrity that we have to stand on to avoid this conflict, because we were involved in this conflict before we were even saved. Paul said in Romans chapter 6, verses 16 through 18, "Know ye not that to whom you yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants you are to whom you obey, whether sin unto death or obedience unto righteousness." But I like what the rest of that says. "But God be thanked." Amen. God be thanked that we came to the realization that we were the servants, we were at once the servants of sins, but we have obeyed from the heart the form of doctrine which was delivered us, being then made free from sin and becoming the servants of righteousness. Amen. We belong to God. We belong to Him. We belong to the kingdom. And God wants to use us for His glory. But the enemy will do any and everything he can to fight. If anyone ever bothered to tell you that this Christian walk was a walk in the park, they haven't served God very long. Amen. If someone told you it was a tiptoe through the tulips, they haven't encountered some things that you've encountered. Amen. I know that there's some people here that have been through some things that can testify that you're going to face some things in your life. Hallelujah. But when you made up your mind to invite Jesus into your heart, you signed on the line the battle that you'd be involved in. Amen. Hebrews chapter 11 tells us of those people of faith who endured hardship, who overcame obstacles, hallelujah, who went through hell and high water, if you please, and yet they remained true because of their faith. And Hebrews 12 goes on to say that we're surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. And there are some here this morning that have been serving God for a whole length of time, and they can testify that there's some giants you're going to face in your life. There's some obstacles that you're going to go through. But for the new converts, I don't want to scare you. Look around you. They're still here, overcoming by faith. Hallelujah. Praising God. And can you give God the glory for the victory that's ours through Jesus Christ this morning? Hallelujah. Paul would not have encouraged us to put on the whole armor if we didn't have a battle to fight. Ephesians 6, put on, verse 11, "Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, his strategies, his devices, his schemes." And believe me, he is constantly at work doing that against our lives. But he said in verse 13, "Wherefore, take the whole armor that God has given you, that you may be able to withstand in that evil day, and having done all, to stand." We have confidence that we can stand because God has given us the tools that we need. Hallelujah. Jesus even said in John chapter 16, verse 33, "In this world, you'll have tribulation. But be of good cheer. I've overcome the world." Hallelujah. Jesus warned us, and excuse me while I open this. Jesus warned us. He even promised us that we would be involved in conflict, that we would go through things. But he says, "I'm telling you this so that you might have peace. Be of good cheer. I've overcome the world." Hallelujah. If you're facing some things this morning, be of good cheer. You're on the right side of the battle. Amen. And God will be your strength and He will be your help. So if we're in a battle, then there must be an enemy. Your mother-in-law is not the enemy. Your boss at work's not the enemy. That child you brought into this life is not your enemy. I think it was the comedian Bill Cosby that said, "I brought you into this world, boy. I can take you out and make another one just like you." I think that's what he said. But regardless of what you're facing in battle, your battle's not with flesh and blood. You turn to your neighbor and say, "You're not the enemy." Some of your spouses, that did y'all just wonders right there. John chapter 10, verse 10 says, "The thief comes not before to steal, kill, and destroy." Behind whatever obstacle you're facing, behind every hindrance in your walk with Christ, even deeply ingrained in your ancestry, there is an attack from hell, an assignment from darkness to steal everything God has for you, to kill the purposes of God in your life, to destroy your effectiveness for the kingdom of God. He uses whatever means, possessions. How many of you have had your possessions attacked? Money, addictions, fame, and even people. but he is behind it to destroy the work of God in your life. So when we see something, we need to see who is at the root of it. Amen. We don't need to just attack what we see coming at us sometimes, but we need to pray and ask God to give us discernment to handle the conflict we are dealing with. You say, Nathan, you have a devil creeping around every corner. Folks, when Satan is intent upon my demise, when he desires to steal everything God has for me, amen, when he tries to make null and void every promise of God, that God has given me, my family, my means of income, my peace of mind, my everything, I'm not just going to sit back and take it, amen, but I'm going to fight him through the power that God gives me, and I'm going to overcome according to the Word of God. Hallelujah. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8 says that, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary or your enemy, the devil, goes about as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. So Peter calls him your adversary. He's your enemy. He's not your friend. He's not going to leave you alone just because you decided to serve Jesus. He's against you. But Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He goes about praying like a hungry lion seeking whom he may devour. He is talking to believers, Peter is, that we should be diligent, alert, fully awake, and always ready to battle him. Amen. Remember in the book of Job, I believe it's verse 7, the devil appeared to God and he said, the Lord said, where have you been? He says, from going up and down throughout the earth, going to and fro in it. And the Bible says that he said, have you considered my servant Job? I don't know that I want to be on that list, but I am working towards it. But I have enough battles as I face. But the Bible says that the devil immediately left the presence of God. He couldn't wait to get a hold of Job. And you know the story, most of you, and how he tore him apart. But the Bible says, as we talked about earlier in the song, he fell on his knees and he praised God and he did not sin with his lips. Hallelujah. The Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away. The enemy may come at you from every angle, but you know what? You give God the praise and the glory and the honor and he will carry you through. At the end of the story, we know that Job was blessed. Amen. Hallelujah. But the whole book of Job, you cannot look at it without realizing that God did everything for his glory. It was for his glory. And if I can give glory to God by overcoming in everything that I face, I am doing what he wants me to do. In the book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 10, it tells us that Satan is the one who stands before God night and day, and he's the accuser of the brethren and the sistren. Amen. Some of you sisters here can say amen. He's always accusing us. He tantalizes you like a billboard ad or a commercial. Oh, you got to try this. It's wonderful. The other day I was watching and I noticed the excitement they put into commercials I hadn't seen in a while. And I was like, good. They go overboard about the dumbest things. People falling on cars and being rate suckers or whatever they call them. whatever. But you know what? The devil will tantalize you. He'll pull you in. And then he'll turn around and accuse you and say, "What? Look at what you did. You're worthless. You're not worthy." But God is able to pull us through. The Bible says if we have overcome with sin, we have an advocate with the Father. Amen. It even tells us that which are spiritual, you which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering yourself. You're going to face some things, amen, that you're going to go through. Hallelujah. So we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness. Our battle is not a physical one, though it may involve some physical. Our battle is not a political one, though it may involve some political. Our real battle is not a natural one, even though we may face some natural setbacks to overcome. The real enemy behind it is Satan and his host of demonic beings. And there are some principalities that have been in operation long before I got here. There are some powers that exist since they were thrown out of heaven. Amen. There's some spiritual wickedness in high places that I can't battle on my own. But praise God, God's kingdom was in existence before these kingdoms ever tried to begin. And his kingdom is an eternal one. Hallelujah. And I can trust Him that what He gives me in His Word, what He empowers me by the power of His Holy Spirit, what is mine because I am a child of God, is going to help me go through and over all of those things that I face from the enemy. Peter said, 2 Corinthians 2:11, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, we're not ignorant of the devil's devices. The Bible sets it out plainly. When you're facing something, stop and think, where is this coming from? What is it after? What is it trying to get me to do? Amen? We're not ignorant of his devices, which leads me to my next point. We must realize that we're in battle. We must realize that we have an enemy. But just as important, we must know the weapons of war that God has given us. Amen? And 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 4 through 5. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down every imagination and every high thing that tries to exalt itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Some of you have faced some things and you wonder if I'll ever get the victory over it. God can give you the victory. Amen. It says, thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. It just takes a constant tenaciousness. Hallelujah. And realizing you don't have to do the devil's bidding. You're a child of the living God. You can overcome by His grace. Hallelujah. There are some in here that can testify that the things that once bothered them 10 years ago have no power over their lives. Why? Because they've learned to apply the weapons and use them that God has given them. They've overcome. I won't go through the full armor that he talks about, but let's look at the shield of faith. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. Y'all have heard lots and read lots about the different weapons, and you can read about them on your own, but let's focus on three areas. Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5, 7, for we walk by faith, not by sight. You got to have your faith meter on, amen, when you face things. You can't just go by sight. In fact, the Holy Spirit will be even so kind as to warn you and give you advance notice of the devil's intentions. You can find that out through prayer or just being worshiping God or just going through your day. I've had advance warning, amen, and some of you have as well. We walk by faith. Now, if there is one thing the devil wants to do, it's to destroy our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. But faith is essential in our walk with God and everything that we deal with spiritually and to see spiritually. Hebrews 11:1, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things that are not seen in the natural. And faith helps you look beyond the natural. Faith helps you see the eternal, everlasting kingdom of God. Faith helps you to comprehend what is the mind of the Spirit. Amen? Faith enables you to receive the Word of God. Faith helps you to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. In the natural, it may look hopeless, but faith sees differently. Hallelujah. In the physical, the doctor may say one thing, but faith in God's Word says another. Hallelujah. And the carnal world says one thing, but faith says another, because our hope is not in the temporal, but in the eternal. Hallelujah. Kingdoms rise and kingdoms fall, but God's truth still marches on. Can you give Him praise this morning? Hallelujah. Remember the children of Israel when they were going to cross the River Jordan and go in and possess the promised land? They sent 12 spies out. And I have to learn how to pace myself. And they sent 12 spies out, and 10 of them came back trembling and fear, and we looked like grasshoppers in the sight. And yes, there were giants in the land. But two of them, Joshua and Caleb, said, we are well able to go up and possess this land. It's a land that flows with milk and honey, just like God said. And if God be for us, who can be against us? Praise God. If you read it, it said, if God said it, then we might as well go in and get it. The Lord will be with us. That's what they said. And yet the people rose up in fear because of the council of the 10 spies. And they wanted to get elected a leader to take them back to the bondage of Egypt. And they wanted to stone Moses and Aaron and Joshua and Caleb with stones right there that morning. They wanted to kill them. You know what? When you stand for Jesus and when you believe what God sees, it doesn't mean that the crowd's going to be with you. Amen. There's going to be some people that rise up against you. There's going to be a fight that's on. Amen. But you know what? Greater is He that's in me than he that's in the world. But because the people were moved by unbelief, the Bible says that God got angry with them. He said, those of you that are 20 years and older will never see the land. Your children will go in and possess it for you. God forbid that any of us should do something that our children have to fight battles that we should have already fought for them. Amen? We should make the way available for them. In Hebrews 3:19 it says, so we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. Every one of them died in the wilderness because of it, and except for Caleb and Joshua, who had faith in their God. Hebrews 11:6, but without faith, it's impossible to please God. For he that comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. Some of you may not have seen some answers. Are you diligently seeking him this morning? We must continue, be steadfast in our faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please Him. Without faith, you cannot see beyond the natural. Amen. But God wants us to look to Him and look to His Word and to walk in faith in spite of what we feel like, in spite of what we're facing, in spite of what we're going through. God is still on His throne. Let the earth rejoice. Hallelujah. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, and we're able to move forward. The enemy is attacking our faith. Matthew chapter 11 tells us a sad, chapter 13 verse 58 tells us a sad story that he did not many mighty miracles because of their unbelief. You can keep God from doing what he wants to do in your life through unbelief. But if you believe him, you will never, never be disappointed. Amen? Hallelujah. I think someone on Facebook this week, one of y'all in here had put, God can do anything but fail. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad that we can trust Him? If we put our confidence and our hope in Him, Satan's objective is to destroy our faith. If he can't trip you up, he'll try to sedate you. To get you, keep you from being too radical for God. He'll get you to where you're hung over with all the cares of this life. You're wrapped around and choked, but we sang this morning about those chains falling. Amen. He's able to remove them. If he can't get you on the side of evil, he'll just get you to settle for what's good and not what's best for you. Amen. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verses 18 and 19. That thou by them, the prophecies that were placed over Timothy's life, might war a good warfare, holding faith and a good conscience, which some have put away concerning faith and made shipwreck of their souls. Paul said some of the saddest words, Demas hath forsaken me, having loved this present world. We have to battle and be at guard, because the enemy doesn't just come up to us one day and try to knock our faith out. He comes at us slowly, one thought at a time. Strongholds are not built in one night. It's built by brick, by brick, by brick, by brick, by brick, and they have to come down in the name of Jesus, and they can if we trust Him. Paul was inspiring Timothy, the youngest pastor of the largest fellowship in Ephesus at that time, to keep the faith by waging a good warfare. He even closed his letter to him in chapter 6, verse 12. He said, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. Amen. Whereunto thou art called, and have professed a good profession before many witnesses. Some of you have made a confession that you're going to follow the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't let the devil disappoint you. Don't let him deter you from what you are planned, what God has for you. Amen. To move forward and move through the things that he throws against you. Right after discussing this, let me quote one other scripture, Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is quick. It's alive. It's powerful. And it's sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing and dividing asunder the soul and the spirit. Your soul may want to do something, but your spirit knows what's right. Amen? the spirit nature within us, fighting against the carnal, as Paul talked about in Romans chapter 7. He wrestled with it. Hallelujah. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. There is therefore now no condemnation to those who walk after the Spirit and not after the flesh. Praise God. We have to learn. You know, salvation is three-dimensional. When Jesus, we're spirit, soul, and body. When He saved us, we're as saved as we'll ever be in our spirit. It's a new man. It's a new creation. Old things have passed away. All things have become new. But the battle is with that carnal nature that we're still dealing with and the flesh. But I'm here to tell you, God is able to help us conquer through His weapons, amen, that He has trained us to. In Matthew chapter I just read that, didn't I? Matthew chapter 11, no, verse 12. He says, "And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent take it by force." He was not going to be Timothy was not going to be able to overcome by being passive or polite or diplomatical. Amen? With the enemy. You've seen people get in a fight, especially one unto death. Maybe you've seen it in the movies. Some of you may have seen it live. I don't know. But you know what happened? I've been at school fights. Especially those cat fights. You hate those, don't you? The girls just pulling the hair. They go crazy. They're going to win. You know, you have this resolve that comes over you. I remember the last day of sixth grade. I'm telling on myself, I shouldn't, but I remember the last day. I was such a good student. Miss Foster was my homeroom teacher, and she was on duty. And Steve Tosh kept jumping on my back. And I told Steve, "Please stop. Stop it. Stop it." Finally, he jumped on me one last time, and we were at it. I mean, we were getting at it. Our children are in the children's room, most of them. So, y'all been in fights before? Oh, my goodness. Miss Foster was down there in no time. We were in the principal's office, Coach Robertson. He was as tall as I am, as big as I am. He had a sawed-off bat with holes drilled in it. Steve Tosh was crying before we even got our whipping. And I was just holding it in, and then he about sent us over his desk. But when you're in a fight, you mean business. You're going to get to the bottom of it. When you realize that your enemy's intent on killing you, when you have had enough of the schemes and his ploys and his tricks, when he's crossed the line with your job, your family, your finances, your health, whatever, you're going to fight back. Amen? Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. We don't wrestle with flesh and blood. I'm not able, even though I'm in the flesh and blood, I'm not able to accomplish. I don't depend on myself to accomplish the winning. I depend upon the Lord, His strength. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 22 and 23 encourage us. Let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith. Paul had that assurance. He says, "I know who I have believed in. I am persuaded that He's able to keep that which I've committed to Him until that day." Amen. That we draw near with that assurance of faith. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering. For He is faithful that has promised. Stand on that. If that's the only scripture you can stand on that. He is faithful that He has promised. God's not a man that He should lie, neither the Son of Man that He should repent. Hath He not spoken, shall He not make it good? Hath He not said it, shall He not accomplish it? His Word is alive and powerful, and it accomplishes everything He sends it forth to accomplish in your life. You can stand on the Word of God when you're in the biggest storm you're going through. Hallelujah. When the wind is blowing, when the waves are high, and know that you will be fine when it all settles down, because He's going to speak, "Peace be still," in your life. God is faithful. He has promised that He is faithful. Next, we must not neglect the Word of God. The sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, Ephesians 6:17 says. It's not only meant for defense, it's also meant for offense. You remember Jesus, when He's led of the Spirit into the wilderness. Fasted 40 days, and Satan came to Him at the end of those 40 days. Tempted Him at His weakest physical moment. But how did Jesus answer Him? it is written. That was that sword driving into the devil. It is written. It is written. When the enemy comes at you at your weakest moment, all you have to do is stand on this. It's written. It's written. It's written. I have full assurance, that blessed assurance that we sing about. Hallelujah. And you remember he used the word of God. Then the devil immediately left him, the Bible says, for a season. He doesn't give up easily. He's tenacious. But greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12 says, for the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. And I want to read the last part. And is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. The Bible says the heart is wicked, deceitfully wicked, and who can know it but God? You get in the word of God, it'll show you things about you that you never knew. It'll show you things about you that you can stand on, that God believes about you. Amen? Hallelujah. Right after discussing the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, Paul said these words, Ephesians 6:18. He said, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Prayer is a weapon of the church that is extremely overlooked and mishandled many times. Paul instructed us to pray always, constantly in prayer. Be prayerful, be alert, be vigilant. And supplication in the Spirit. There's some things, Paul was talking about Spirit-led prayer. There's some things that God, you can have prayer for needs, and then you can have prayer enter into that intercession with the Spirit. Amen? And He will give you direction. Paul said, we pray and ask prayer so much of the time for us that we need what we need and want. And there's nothing wrong with that to an extent, but we must be as accomplished, if not more, at praying the will of the kingdom before we pray for our needs. Amen? The Lord taught us on prayer in Matthew chapter 6. And He says, when you pray, enter into the closet, shut the door, and pray for your to your Father in secret. You know, I remember people who I knew of them at church growing up, and they could say these, but thou, la, 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 just pray these big, deep prayers. And their sons or their daughters were friends with me, and they never pray at home. It's all right to pray in public. It's all right to lead in prayer. Amen. I praise God for Brother Nealon, how he led us to the throne of grace this morning. Amen. But we've got to have a habit of prayer of our own that nobody knows about but God. Amen. We enter into that closet. We shut the door and we pray to Him. And He says when the heathen pray, they do it through vain repetitions. But you know what? You can go to God and talk to Him just like you talk to someone else and tell Him what you're going through. You don't have to know the these and thous. You don't have to know that. You just be real and honest with Him and He'll begin to lead you in your prayer. Amen. And you'll begin to accomplish much for God and you'll be able to overcome the things that you're going through. And He said, after this manner, pray, our Father which art in heaven, we know it, hallowed be thy name. God desires praise and worship before He desires anything else from you. The Bible even says He seeks such to worship Him, that worship in spirit and truth. And when I set Him in His place in my life, when I elevate God in my life, then He has His rightful place and my problems seem small compared to Him. Amen? Everything else falls in its place. And God desires that praise from us. And thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. He wants His purpose. Pray the will of the kingdom before we pray for our own personal needs. That His kingdom will be established. That His will, His plan, His purposes will be done in the earth realm just as they originate in heaven. Hallelujah. Give us this day our daily. Then go into our prayer. And He will provide. Amen. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but we can overcome evil. And pray the will of the kingdom. And then He said, deliver us from evil. But for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. We end in praise and worship to Him. We give Him the glory that's due His name. It's all right for you to pray to God about things that you're going through. But put him in his proper place. Amen. Let him know, I trust you, Lord, implicitly. You are the ruler of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. I depend upon you. You are my God and none else. Hallelujah. I come to you with these needs, and then I give you praise and glory and honor because I know you heard me and I know you're able to meet those needs. Prayer is so integral in our battle offensively and defensively with the enemy. It is so essential to our strength in battle. How many of you have ever seen that church sign? Prayerlessness equals powerlessness. But on the other hand, prayerfulness equals powerfulness. If you want to have the strength for the battle, go into that closet and shut the door, hallelujah, humbling ourselves before God and close the door. I don't care what you're going through, but I promise you that you will stop fighting in the natural if you'll stop figuring it out and you close that door and go into the secret place of the Most High. God will move heaven and earth on your behalf. Hallelujah. Prayer is powerful. James tells us in chapter 5, verse 16, the effective prayer, fervent prayer of a righteous man, a man who is in right standing with God, accomplishes, avails much. I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what you're facing. But if you want God to move, go before Him and pray. And He will hear. The Bible says that when Solomon dedicated the temple, he said his prayers before the Lord, they offered all the sacrifices, and God promised. He said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. If you want God to move in the behalf of what you're dealing with, you're going to have to do some praying. Amen? Prayer moves God. Prayer moves the throne of God. Things happen in the Spirit because of prayer. You know, some of the services we've been having here lately isn't because God just decided to show up. Somebody's been praying. Somebody's been interceding. Amen. And God doesn't just show up so we can have those doodads go up and down our backbone. Amen. He comes to speak to us. He comes to guide us. He comes to direct us. He comes to refresh us. But somebody's been praying. Somebody's been asking God. In closing, the battle is not our battle. 2 Corinthians 10:3 says, for though we walk in the flesh, we don't war after the flesh. We don't lean on the arm of the flesh, our strength, or our own wisdom. If I tried to handle the things that I faced in my life, I would make a mess of them if it wasn't for the grace of God stepping in and Him working on my behalf. We need the Holy Spirit in everything we do. The Spirit of God directs us in our faith, in the Word, and in our prayer. We need the Holy Spirit. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6, not by might, not by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. Jesus said, the one that endures to the end, the same shall be saved. I believe the Proverbs or Song of Solomon, he said, I have seen those that have started the race and haven't finished. I have seen the mighty dressed for battle go out and not return home. Hallelujah. It's not our strength that we depend upon, but the strength of the Lord, the Almighty. And greater is He that's in me than he that's in the world. Not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit of God who helps us. Paul said it like this in 1 Corinthians 2:5, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. I don't depend upon what man can do for me. I depend upon God. People can let you down. Bankers cannot come through for you. Amen. Some of you have went to the bank and wanted a loan so bad and you felt that disappointment. Huh? Some of you went to the doctor and you've left his office disappointed. Some of you have went for a job interview and you've left disappointed. But I'm telling you, you go before the Father and never be disappointed in Him. Hallelujah. He will come through for you. Thank you, Jesus, that our faith is not standing in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. I need the Holy Spirit of God because He will lead and guide me into all truth. He will show me things to come. He will be another comforter, the other self of God, the Spirit of Christ. Hallelujah. And Jesus said, everything that the Father's revealed to me, I've given to Him to show to you. Hallelujah. He will lead and guide us. He won't mislead us. And He dwells with you, but He shall be in you a spring of living water that shall never run dry. We need the power of the Holy Ghost. The reason we are not able sometimes to accomplish is because we're not led by the Spirit of God. Isaiah chapter 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and His glory from the rising of the sun, when the enemy shall come in like a flood. The Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. I'm glad I don't have to fly under my own standard. I'm glad I have backing me up the power of God. Hallelujah. That the enemies tremble when they see His banner. Hallelujah. Jehovah Rapha, the Lord is my banner. Hallelujah. Jehovah Nisi, the Lord is my banner. I'm so glad that I can rest under Him, that He sings over me with love. Hallelujah. That His banner over me is love. And that I can be faced with anything in this life, but I can overcome because He is Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Let me close with this scripture, Ephesians chapter 6, verse 13. We said it earlier, but wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in that evil day, and having done all, to stand. I want to encourage you this morning. You're not facing this battle alone. Paul said, pray with all perseverance for all the saints. We should lift one another up, encourage one another in that battle that we're going through. Not only that, we have a host in heaven who stand behind us as witnesses that we can overcome, and they will encourage us. We have the living Word of God, which tells us on every corner, in every book, that we can overcome no matter what we're facing. God is true, and let every man else be a liar. Hallelujah. Would you stand with me as the musicians come. Winning in warfare. I know some of you here this morning have been facing some giants. You've been battling some things that are heavy upon you even now this morning. But you know what? I hope you've been encouraged by the Word of God to step out and let Him intervene on your behalf. Because Jesus has won it all. We just have to put God in His rightful place in our lives. Some of you may be here this morning and you have never really let go and let God intervene in your life. Maybe you've never served Him. Let's begin to pray together. Hallelujah. Some of you can pray in the Spirit as the Lord leads you. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to pray audibly. Lift up your voice to the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we love You. We praise You. We give You thanks. We give You glory. We give You honor. Hallelujah. 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 Maybe you have never given your life to the Lord. I want you to raise your hand right now and say, Nathan, I want to give my life to the Lord wholly because I need Him on my side. I'm going through a lot of things. He's able to do far beyond what we ask or imagine this morning. Have Your way, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Maybe you're here this morning and you say, Nathan, I've been going through a battle. It seemed overwhelming, but the Word of God encouraged me this morning, and I'm going through because of His Word, because His promise to be with me. Raise your hand this morning. I believe God. Yes, yes. Hallelujah, yes. Anyone else? You've been going through a struggle. You've been going through a struggle. Sorry to admit you're going through a struggle. We just need to know the answer, amen? Someone else this morning, I'm facing a battle, but I know God is my strength and He is my help. Hallelujah. Yes, I see that. Any other? There's some here this morning that can testify to you. They've been through the flood, but they've come out on the other side. God will be there for you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's continue to pray, folks. Hallelujah. Lord, have Your way in this service. Lord, have Your way in this service. Your Word is not going to return void. Hallelujah. It will accomplish what You send it forth to accomplish. Lord, I pray that it accomplishes everything You desire to this morning in every life. In every life. If you desire prayer, would you come forward at this time, those of you that raised your hands? We want to agree with you. Amen. If you desire prayer for something you're facing, something you're battling. Come up here with me across the front. Don't be afraid. Let God have His way this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. People praying in the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Lord, we ask you to have your way in people's lives. Hallelujah. Believe in the power of God to resurrect some things that seem dead. Hallelujah. Believe in the power of God to provide where some things are lacking. Believe in the power of God to strengthen people that are battle weary. Sometimes we go through battle, we can't go through it alone. We need our saints and our brothers, sisters in the Lord to strengthen us. Hallelujah. Would some of you prayer warriors come up behind these and find a place of prayer? I believe there's still, I just want to leave it open for those. There's still some here this morning. You're facing a battle. You've come through some things, and you need the Lord's strength to help you. We're here to agree with you in prayer that God is able to do far beyond what we ask or imagine this morning. Hallelujah. Anyone else before we turn the direction of this service to prayer? Yes, hallelujah. Someone come and stand with this one. Hallelujah. 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 Someone come and stand with Brother Terry. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God's able. God's able. God's able. Hallelujah. Let's give a praise to the Lord. God's able. Hallelujah. Greater is He that is in us. Let someone come and pray with this brother right here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everyone, let's have everyone with someone. Thank you, Jesus. Anyone else before we turn this order of the service? Victory is ours in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, you do not have to deal. God can give you insight into your battle. Hallelujah. You can gain the victory. You know, there's big things that I have faced in my life that God has already given me confirmation. He is going to take care of it, and I rest and I trust in Him, and it's almost as if it's already done. I can see it in the Spirit. It's already done. Why? Because He gave me such assurance. Let's begin to pray. Hallelujah. Everyone lift their hands. Let's begin to pray. Oh, encouraged this morning. Those of you that came forward for prayer, can we testify to them that God is faithful? Amen. Amen. Love on some of those that have come to the altar this morning for those needs, because we encourage one another. One of these days we might need their support and their strength. Hallelujah. Have you been blessed this morning by the Word of God? Have you been encouraged? Know this, that God, if God be for us, who can be against us? But the battle's already won. We just need to rest in Him. Jesus said, I tell you this so that you can rest. In this world you'll have tribulation. But be of good cheer. I've overcome the world. Remember to be here next Sunday. Pastor is preaching on breaking yokes, the anointing that breaks the yokes, I believe, and you will be blessed. If you were here on Wednesday nights, you would have heard his preaching on the prevailing word. Amen. Get those CDs if you haven't gotten those. Be blessed in the Lord this weekend. I'm delighted to have my brother and my sister and my niece with me, both nieces. Hallelujah. And y'all have a wonderful day with family and friends. Greet one another with a handshake or a hug. Amen. In the name of the Lord. Thank you for being here.